The fans want to call you out on that tweet. Just
what, what do you have up your sleeve? Yeah.
Huh? No, look, look. I mean, I'm with Munguia, 1,000%. 1,000%. That's my guy. And you watch. When it gets closer to the fight, ooh, I'm going to unleash some bombs, baby.
Did you feel a little dissed there that he didn't acknowledge you at the podium? And it was a little awkward, you guys' interaction, just you being on stage and him.
It's okay. You know, he knows who his dad is. It's okay.
Did they try to keep you away, Oscar? Did they try to keep you away from being in that podium? They did?
Keep me away. You can't be in a press conference. You can't take pictures. You can't give interviews. What are you talking about? Then it's gonna be like being at church. Every press conference, every face-off, every no. Because Munguia respects him, and I respect Munguia for doing that. But it's like, I know Canelo, you know, and we got to spark something here. And guess who has to do it? I have to spark it, so.
Oscar, speaking of super middleweight, obviously, you know, Canelo's facing against, you know, your guy, Jaime Munguia. What does Munguia bring to the table that could cause, you know, Canelo not only problems, but maybe, you know, potentially beat a Saul Alvarez on fight night?
Aside from youth, I think the experience that he has with Freddie Roach is going to be one of the keys. But activity, you know, Jaime Munguia throws a lot of combinations, and when he has you hurt or he smells, you know,
it's like a shark on water.
Yeah, it's like he'll jump at you and just try to finish you, you know, instantly. So I think the fact that you know, all those combinations with, you know, the youth, the jab, oh man, we've been working on something with him. Oh, the jab is gonna be key. His footwork. I mean, Freddie has him bouncing on his toes, crying out loud. So yeah, it's gonna be a good fight, you know. And this event is gonna be a huge event on the zone. On Amazon, so it's on a global scale. So, you know, are we going to see the changing of the guards, or are we going to see Canelo, you know, reign supreme once again? So it's a fun matchup.
Oscar, you're more excited today compared to the Canelo press conference that you said was boring.
Yeah, boring as hell.
Congratulations on the deal with the YouTube theater.
Thank you, man.
Stadium.
Yeah,
tell us a little bit about that.
Sure. No, we feel very proud to be partnering up with Hollywood Park, YouTube Theater. This is history right now in the making, and so we want to make sure, yeah, that obviously Southern California LA boxing stays alive and well. And it's, and as you can tell, I mean, this theater is beautiful. It's amazing. It's great for fights. You guys were here for the first one, right?
The Rocha one. Mm-hmm. Not a bad seat in the arena.
I mean, the top seat is probably the best seat, right? So, yeah, we expect a sellout crowd this Saturday night. It's gonna be special.
We're sure they're making history over Galamarin. If he's successful on Saturday, what does the future hold for you and Surdo and Golden Boy, just trying to put on, like you said, the big fights?
Yeah, look, the one mistake we don't make, or that we try not to make, is overlook opponents, especially a guy like Arson. Arson, he's been world champion since 2018. I don't know if you've seen his style, but he comes fighting hard, guns blazing, face first, throwing combinations. It's going to be an exciting fight. I think Surdo's last performance with Joe Smith in Vegas, you know, it proved to us, to everyone, that a big guy like Surdo can move like a lightweight. It was pretty impressive what I was watching up in that ring that night. But now fighting Arson, I think styles are going to clash. I think that Surdo's pride is going to get in the way a little bit. You know, but we love that. You know, when your pride gets in the way and you have to fight. We love that as fans. So, yeah, it's going to be exciting.
Surdo was the first, you know, Mexican super middleweight champion. What would it mean, you know, for Golden Boy and obviously for Mexico, for Surdo to become the, you know, the first cruiserweight champion?
Cruiserweight now? Yeah. I mean, it's history. History in the making. I mean, it's incredible. It really is an opportunity that Surdo must seize. You know, it's right there in front of him. I mean, he can become the first, super middleweight champion in Mexico? The first cruiserweight? I mean, it's a dream come true for him. I mean, it's amazing.
I'm Ellie Sekback. Ellie Sekback reporting.
But ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.